Hey everyone, I'm Joshua.
And I'm Andrea.
Not Caleb.
Not Caleb.
We're not twins either. I wish we were.
I know.
I'm not as pretty as Andrea, but that's okay. How's everyone doing today?
Good, good. You guys know me as the face of social media, and you probably know Josh from a lot of things. You have been Samson.
Mm-hmm.
You've done voiceovers for us. You've done tour spots.
Oh.
Most recently,
Joshua
as Joshua.
It blows the mind. It's the role I've been waiting to play my entire life.
Tell us a little bit about that.
My goodness. So I'm as an actor, you get a chance to portray a lot of different people, and I was named after Joshua of the Bible. So it is really cool that I got the opportunity to play my namesake. So it was something I was really excited to do, really to delve into what Joshua may have been experiencing as he went through his life facing these different processes. I think we learn a lot about Moses' perspective, but we don't always hear a lot about Joshua and what he might have been going through.
Absolutely. And I had the privilege of being on the set as a production assistant and saw the behind the scenes, and you really, really embraced. That's something that I so love and appreciate about you. It doesn't matter whether it's a voice work or you're on camera, tour spot, on location, in the studio, you always work as unto the Lord with all your heart, not unto man. And that's why we keep having you back, because we love your dedication to our Savior. But the process that you went through in order to play Joshua, what did you do? Were you method acting?
See, this is a very politically correct way of leaning into saying, like, you didn't bathe for a month and stop shaving
you
for six.
Shaving.
I did actually, you know, it's
you
funny.
Let your hair go.
Right, yeah. For so long, I've played biblical characters, as you know, and so I had the long hair and I had the beard, and then I started getting gray and middle-aged, and so I was like, no, and I went through my midlife crisis and cut it all off. But y'all guys approached me for this part, and I did. I stopped cutting my hair, I stopped shaving, and I really, you know, my brother Caleb, you'll seen him on Beard Bible Brothers, such a student of the Bible and of history, and so I really tapped into him for a lot of the perspective of Joshua. Ken Berg, you know, wrote the scripts for it, and so we spent a lot of time, more so than just the look, because the look's amazing. And I'm really not method from the standpoint of, you know, I didn't, you know, go live in the wilderness for 40 years because I don't like to sweat. But I really, I put these people around me that had a lot of insight to draw from, like I said, what he might have been going through. I wanted to understand what it's like to have a call from God, but to spend your whole life waiting for it to transpire. Mm. I think we get caught up a lot today in the immediacy of our society around us. And so when something doesn't happen by the time you get 18 and then 25 and then 30 and then 40, you start thinking, okay, the plan's done, the plan's gone. But you look at guys like Joshua and Caleb in the Bible, and we're talking 80s, early 90s, you know, to start that thing that you know them for.
Right.
What you read about them in the Bible really wasn't so much when Joshua was 30 years old or 40 years old. It was in the twilight of his life, the nursing home time that we have in today's society. And I thought that was really interesting.
Yeah, it was great. We so appreciate, again, what you do for us and what you bring to the table. And we thank you for being with us today and for always, always doing your best and again, working as unto the Lord.
It's truly a blessing for me to be able to do this. I know that when I started with zolalevittministries years and years ago, a lot of what I did was behind the scenes. Wow. And I enjoy that part of it too, but I, at heart, am a storyteller. And to me, every one of you, every life on this planet that was created by the Father has a story to tell. Before He even created the world around us, He created us and our plans and our destiny. To me, that says that the Father's focus for us is that journey and that story. Even more so than it was the beautiful birds and the beautiful plants and all. He gave us this wonderful earth. But first thing He had was to create a plan and a journey for your life.
Amen.
And so when I think about that, at heart of me, that's what really led me, I believe, into acting and whatnot, was to pursue the story of life, of each life, and to know that every life has a purpose and a reason for it. We can get caught up in the what I call the highlight reels of life, right? Isn't that what history does for us?
Mm-hmm.
It's a little demo of the best parts of these people's lives. And we've even investigated some of the negative sides of their life. But we forget in our lives today, when we go through things, good, bad, and ugly, that there's so much more than just that moment. There's a bigger picture.
Right.
Don't let go. Don't give up. And these sound like little inspirational quotes, but it's the truth of it. There is a reason that you're here. And it's so much more than just the adversity that you're facing.
Amen. Amen. So, thank you so much.
Yeah. So I encourage you guys at home, tune in for the Joshua series. It's
yes.
coming up. It's coming really soon. It's a multi-part deal, and it's going to be really exciting. Y'all guys are going to get to see Joshua from the time he started off in his youth all the
yes,
way to the twilight
everything.
Of his life.
Yes.
And that was another cool thing, too, getting to play the span of a life. So really, tune in for those episodes coming up. You get to hear the deep insight into the scripture. Behind it from Dr. Seif.
Yes.
And so that's going to be amazing to hear
the
theology
and
to see
yes.
the representation of
yes.
it. And hopefully you'll take something from the story from a different perspective that maybe you hadn't before.
I love it. Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you for having me.